The event was held at the residence of presidential candidate and former minister Milroy Fernando.
After the SLPP was formed, I realized that it was destroying the SLFP as it went forward. We must defeat the SLPP. It is only if we defeat the SLPP that we can protect the SLFP in the future, according to the original policies of the late Banda Nayaka. The young leader says, I will appoint a good prime minister who has no allegations against him and any record linked to corruption or theft. He says he will not appoint the same old cabinet. He is right. Now there is no point in appointing people like us. This is the truth. We are aging. We were also part of the corrupt cabinet. If we take the wrong decision in the upcoming presidential election, I too will suffer the same fate of Tajuddin.
මේ කතා කරන මටත් වෙන්නේ අර තාජුඩීන්ට වෙච්ච දේ තමයි.
Ever since I handed over the party to Rajapaksa, he started to destroy it. The start was when Rajapaksa visited the party headquarters and asked them to remove the photo frames of SWRD Bandaranaike, Sirimavo Bandaranaike and Chandrika Bandaranaike. He then informed the party secretary to refrain from registering any branch. During the 9 years Rajapaksa served as the chairman, he did not allow any branch to be registered. This was told to me by the then secretary general of the SLFP, Maithripala Sirisena. Maithripala Sirisena, who could not stand this anymore, sent letters to open branches for registration. Mahinda Rajapaksa had then summoned Maithripala Sirisena and had questioned him as to what he was doing. Mahinda Rajapaksa had then said, I have given the responsibility to my younger brother Basil. Let him do it. The original SLFP does not agree with the Rajapaksas. The true and original SLFP does not like looting. The SLFP had no tradition of looting from the general public. Just because ministers criticize us, we did not murder them. We did not kill or harass journalists. So this party does not agree with them. They were in power for 9 years. They destroyed the party and joined hands with casino dealers. They appointed two of the largest drug dealers to the cabinet. They were appointed to the defense ministry. They appointed drug lords to the ministry, which was supposed to protect the people. They destroyed the party, destroyed the country with murder and corruption, but boast they won the war. It is praiseworthy that they ended the war, not won the war. But just because they ended the war does not mean we should let them destroy the country. This is why I do not approve this. I engage in policy-driven politics. Even if they threaten me, I cannot agree. I have received messages questioning as to why I oppose Gotabaya and Mahinda Rajapaksa. They say they will come to any place I request them to. But I said no, because I know that if they come into power, they can kill me. My children say if they come into power, to leave the country the very next day. They won't come to power. But while they were in power within 24 hours, they removed all of my security personnel. If it is so for us, how will it be for you?
Aapu gamam marana. Tamunnaasala etara apita kumunan tamunnaasala.